Hi everyone, and welcome back to Casper's Dapp Developer Series. My name is Dylan, and today we'll be deploying the contract that we built in the last video using a Node.js script. This video will continue where we left off, so open the terminal to the working directory from the last video. In your project directory, run npm init-y, then npm install Casper.js SDK. Then create a new file, index.js. Then open it in a text editor. I'm using VS Code. Start by requiring the node package fs that we will use to load in our compiled smart contract. Now we need to require some objects from the Casper.js SDK. We need runtime args, CL value builder, contracts, Casper client, and keys. The first thing we'll do is create a new Casper client object. This requires a node URL, and for this we can go to testnet.cspr.live, tools, and connected peers. Grab a node address with the port ending in 35,000, go back to your application, paste it in, prepend it with http://, put port 7777/RPC. Note that if you were using the mainnet, you would want to just go to cspr.live. Next, we need to create the contract object, and now we'll want to load in our keys. We don't have keys currently, so let's create a key pair with the Casper client. Head back over to your terminal, and in your project directory, run Casper client, keygen, and keys. This will create a key pair in the keys directory. If you don't have the Casper client installed, watch the prerequisites video to learn how to install it. Now to fund this account with testnet CSPR, let's go to testnet.cspr.live, open up the Casper signer, type in your password to unlock your vault, import an account, click upload, click the secret key file in the keys directory, name your imported account, and import. Now close this page, go to tools, faucet, click I'm not a robot, and request tokens. Now let's wait for this transaction to deploy successfully. Let's click the deploy hash. Once it completes successfully, you should see status success, and you should be able to click on your public key and see that you have 1000 testnet CSPR. Now we can go back to our editor and load in our key pair using the load key pair from private file method. Now we need to load in our WebAssembly contract, and we'll need to store it as a uint8 array. We can use fs.readfilesync to pull in our contract from the target wasm32 unknown unknown release directory that we looked at earlier. Now let's write the install function. So first we'll need a new set of runtime arguments, which we'll use runtimeArguments.fromMap and clValueBuilder.string to create a CL value of type string. Also notice that our key message here matches our runtime argument message here. Now you can create a new deploy with contract.install, and we will pass in a set of arguments here. So we'll say wasm, because we'll need our WebAssembly, our arguments, and now the payment in motes. We will do 20 CSPR, which is equivalent to 20 billion motes. Now we need the sender's public key, so we use keys.publicKey. Then the network name, which is Casper Test. If you're on the mainnet, it's just Casper, and then an array of signing keys. An array of signing keys is used here for those that would like to use multi-signature functionality, but for our case, we will just use the one key pair keys. Lastly, we can set up a try-catch block and call client.putDeploy, which will send our deploy to a node and execute it on the network. Now we can install the contract by calling install. And when it completes, we can log out the deploy hash, and if we catch an error, we can log out that error. To test it out, head back to your terminal and run node index.js. All right, now we have the deploy hash. Copy this deploy hash and head back to testnet.cspr.live, then paste it in the search bar and click enter. After about 30 seconds, we can see that it was a success, and if we go back to our account and click named keys and refresh, we can see we have the Hello World contract right here. Clicking on the Hello World contract hash, we can find out more information about the contract, like its entry points and its named keys. If we click on the message UREF, we can see that it has the text Hello World. Great, so now that our contract is installed and everything's working properly, you can head back over to your text editor, comment out the install function, and create a new function update message. This function will look very similar to our install function, but one key difference is that we need to use contract.setContractHash. Go ahead and grab this value from your named keys. Similarly to last time, you'll need to create runtime arguments. I've changed the text from Hello World to Hello Again. Now instead of contract.install, we will now use contract.callEntryPoint, which will use its own set of arguments, the first being the entry point, which is update message, the next being the runtime arguments, then the sender's public key, then the network, which is Casper test, and the payment in motes, which will be a lot cheaper this time around. So we will use one CSPR, or 1 billion motes, and then the array of signing keys. Now just like before, we'll use our try-catch block with putDeploy. Now just like with testing our install function, we can run update MSG, then get the deploy hash, and log an error if we encounter one. Making sure that the install call is commented out, we can save our file, head back to our terminal, and rerun node index.js. We'll get a different deploy hash. We can go over to cspr.live and enter it. Once it succeeds, we can verify that it worked by going back to our account, named keys, to the Hello World contract, to its named keys, clicking message, and we can see that it says hello again. Now that we can update the message from within our script, let's head back and comment out our update message and write a function to query the message. Create a new function query message that just sets the contract hash to the same hash that we used earlier and returns contract.queryContractData with the path message. Then call the function like we did earlier, except this time logging the result instead of the deploy hash. Now making sure install and update message are commented out, we can head back over to our terminal and run node index.js, and we should get hello again. That's all for this video. In the description, you'll find a link to the GitHub repository, which contains the script and the smart contract. Remember to like and subscribe if you found this video useful. If you'd like to be notified when new videos are released, hit the bell icon below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.